So in your downloads folder, you will be able to see USB web server, and inside that the subfolder USB web server. Right click on USB web server application and then run as administrator. Make sure that you run this as administrator. And then see whether Apache and MySQL are running. See whether Apache and MySQL are running. And then go to root dir folder by selecting on this button, root dir. And then you'll be able to see under USB web server, which we have opened right now, there is another subfolder called root. So this navigates to that subfolder root automatically once you press this button. Let's create a subfolder inside this called my app. Another subfolder inside this called my app. Go inside that and then right click, new text document. Now you can see in this text document, you cannot see any file extension. .txt should be there as the file extension, but I cannot see any file extension here. So what you can do is go to Viv and then tick the option file name extensions. In Windows 7, this is available under tools, folder options. Under folder options, you can select file name extensions to view the file name extensions. As a result, I can see .txt in here. And then let's name this file as, okay, there are some kids also saying that they cannot still hear anything. Please select join audio. I hope other kids can hear me, yeah? Okay. Right, so back to work. So this is one option of one way of creating a PHP file or HTML file, whatever the file that you want. Just take a new text document here and then just rename it with the required file extension, right? For example, in here, I'm going to create a file called myform.html, myform.html. And it's asking whether you want to change this file name extension or not. And click yes, and you'll be able to see that text file is no longer a text file now, it is a HTML file. Okay, this is one way of creating, or otherwise you can simply delete this file. There's another way. When you are inside this folder under root and my app subfolder, in your downloads, you'll be able to see another one which you have downloaded from the website, which is Notepad++, which you must have extracted. Once you download this Notepad++ from the website, you should extract it and you'll be able to see Notepad folder. Go inside the Notepad folder and then there's this notepad++portable.exe. Go ahead, run this as an administrator. Okay, back to this. So here I have this notepad plus plus. We have just started, right? Do not say restart. We have just started the session, right? So I have this notepad plus plus software which I'm going to use to type the coding. It is nothing but a text editor, but with syntax highlighting, right? And so on the downloads folder, I have a USB web server, and inside USB web server, there is another folder called USB web server. And then we have this root subfolder inside that. And we have created my app folder inside that. You should save all your files within this my app folder. If the my app folder does not exist, you should create the folder, right? Okay. So I have opened Notepad++ now. Notepad++. And I'm going to create my first file just by typing HTML. And wait. Okay. Just by typing HTML. HTML and then file, save as, in my downloads folder under USB web server. There's another folder called USB web server, and inside root folder I have just created a subfolder called my app. Go inside that folder and mention the file name. Let's name it as myform.html. myform.html. Save it. Once you save it as the HTML file, you can see the required HTML highlighting, keyword highlighting, tag highlighting is done by Notepad++ automatically. There is one significant advantage of using this text editor, right? So you can see inside downloads USB web server, subfolder USB web server, root subfolder, and inside my app, now I have a file called myform.html. And now I'm about to type the content. Right. So head/head, body/body. I'm going to have a title in this web page. Saying, insert items, and within body I'm going to include a form, an HTML form, form action always states where the data should go upon submission of this form. A form can be submitted, a content of a form can be submitted, So form action says where the data should go. Even though I have not created another file where the data should go, I am going to mention here the name of the file which I am about to create, that is insert.php. Action insert.php, which means if someone is going to submit this form, all the data that is entered within this form will be sent to insert.php file. Method, the way of sending, since I don't have any plan to include sensitive personal data inside this, I'll be using get method to send the data. So that way I open and close the form. And then next option, the next one that we have to do is to include one text field, input type text. I'm giving it a name. The name of the text field is item name. Item name. And there is a placeholder text in it mentioning enter the item name. Enter the item name. A placeholder text. And then I'm going to include a submit button, input type submit. Submit. And value of the button, insert item. So even though it's a submit button, by default the caption on the submit button is going to be the text submit. But when I mention the value, you can see a different caption. The caption is going to be insert item. Okay, so save this. I'm going to save this. Okay, for the kids, those who haven't done this yet, please take a new file, myform.html, which should be created inside the root folder. Don't forget that. Please quickly create this file and type the content. So everybody type this file now. Everyone finish? Myform.html. Please be quick. I can't give you 1 hour for this. The session long only for 30 minutes. The duration for this one is just 40 minutes altogether. Fixing the mic for like more than 10 minutes. I'll be giving everyone just 30 seconds more. Myform.html. Yeah, we'll think of another session later on. Okay, has everyone finished? Is there anyone who's still doing this? Okay, so proceeding with the rest. So this myform.html, do not just double click and open it. I mean, you can obviously do that. You can just double click and open this, right? But do not open it because we are going to submit the content to insert.php file, which does not exist yet, right? But to support PHP, just opening this with the web browser is not enough. I mean, you'll be able to view HTML content using only the web browser, but to view the PHP content, we need to have a web server configured with PHP. So here we have USB web server for that purpose, to view the PHP content. So therefore, I hope all of you must have opened USB web server. Right, USB web server. Make sure that you have run it as an administrator. Run it as an administrator and then make sure Apache and MySQL both are working. Right, you should be able to see these two green color signs if Apache and MySQL both are working. And then click localhost. Click localhost. And the folder that I have created, you can see it's appearing in here. My app, click on this folder. And my file is myform.html. And you should be able to see the same. I have one text box with one submit button. And if I'm going to type something here, say pencil and click insert item. Currently, you can see my URL is myapp/myform.html, which I am in now. Once I click insert item, you can see it is getting changed to insert.php. It is trying to search for a find. It is trying to submit the content for a file called insert.php. And question mark, you can see in the URL, item name equals pencil. Here, item name means the name that I have given to our text box, and pencil is the value which is included in the text box. You can see here, the text box name that I have given is item name. So you can see as a parameter, item name is there, equals means the value that we have entered to this, which is pencil. Okay, but insert.php file is not there, so we have to create this file. Just keep the HTML file and take another file. This is going to be our PHP file. USB web server, you have to run it as an administrator. And yeah, save this file, PHP file, in the same folder, root my app, where you can find this myform.html file. Save it as insert.php. Insert.php. Insert.php and then click save. So what I did was, now I'll be able to see inside my app folder, I can see myform.html file and insert.php file. Two files are there. Myform.html file, which I have coded before, and insert.php file, which I'm going to code now. Okay. So myform.html file is submitting some content to insert.php file. We could see it here. When I click back, we could see it here. When I insert something, say, mention some value here and press insert item button, we can see the content is sent to insert.php. Now it does not show the file not found because I have created the file. So not only HTML sending content to the PHP file, the PHP file has a responsibility of getting that content which is sent from the HTML file. So to get the content which is sent from the HTML file to the PHP file, to receive it properly, I'm going to use $_get method. So here, I'm going to create a variable, $item equals $_get the value from item name. Here item name means the name which I have given to my text box in the previous file. Item name. $_get method means, here get method means the method that I have defined in my HTML form. $item is the variable that I have created to store that value. So $item equals $_get item name. So whatever the content which I have typed in there, maybe pen or pencil or whatever the item that I'm going to mention in there in the previous HTML file, will be now coming to the insert.php file and getting stored in a variable called $item, right? If you want to check it, we can use the echo function of PHP to display the content. Echo, when I say $item, echo and $item, with or without double quotes, this is gonna work. Echo $item. Save this, go to your HTML file, insert item. Now you can see the item which I have typed in my previous page is now shown in my PHP file. It is now visible in my PHP file. Because in my PHP file, what I did was just receive the content which is coming from my HTML file and stored it in $item variable and then displayed it in the website. Displayed it in the website. Okay, so here in my insert.php web page, I can see item name which is getting displayed. That is not what should happen. What should happen is that I'm going to send this content to a database. So to do that one, we have to create a database. I hope up to this extent, everybody has done and followed me. Is there anyone who has not yet created insert.php file? Please respond in the chat window. Okay, if you have done, you don't need to say done. Those who haven't done this yet, please mention. So now you must be able to see the two files under root folder, my app folder. I have two files created. One is insert.php and the other one is myform.html. Right. Now I'm about to do the most important part, that is creating the database. Follow the steps carefully. Follow the steps carefully. So here I have opened up a USB web server. And then to access the root folder, I use root dir option here. To open our file via the web browser, I use the localhost option. To create the database, I have to use PHP MyAdmin interface. PHP MyAdmin interface allows us to create databases within MySQL server. So click PHP MyAdmin. Click PHP MyAdmin, and then afterwards you can see username, root, and password USBW already mentioned in there. You can mention the same username and password here, and then click go. So here on to your left, you can see the databases which are created. There are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 databases which are created by default. I'm going to create a new database for this. Databases, create database. Our database name is going to be live. Live. Click here, databases, and then enter the database name as live, and then click create button. And then afterwards, you'll be able to see live database appears in the left list of databases under PHP MyAdmin. You can see here live database. Click on that live database. And then straight away, we have this option of creating a table, because my database do not have any tables which are created inside it. So I'm going to create a table inside this. This table name is going to be items. The table name is going to be items. And the number of columns in this table is going to be 2. Table name items, number of columns 2. I hope all of you could follow up to this step. Is there anyone who is still proceeding? So the ones those who have completed up to this extent, can you please mention whether you are done or not in the group chat? Cool, right. Fine. So number of columns 2, name items, items, number of columns 2, and then click go. Okay. And then I have these two rows, these two rows to input the two names of my columns. The first name of the column is going to be item ID. Item ID. Item ID, all simple. Let's make it all simple. Item ID, no spaces. No spaces, all simple, item ID. And then the next one is going to be, not Teran Subasinghe, it should be item name. All simple, no spaces. Item name. And then first one type should be int, keep it as it is. The second field, data type, change it to varchar. Sounds a bit awkward, but varchar. And then length, 100. Length, 100. Okay. Looks like I have to use a magnifier. You can see item ID, item name. Item ID is int. Type is varchar. Length 100. Item name length is 100. And then in item ID, there is something that you have to do. In item ID, there is this option in that row. Index. There's a drop down list called index. I hope you can see that. Index, select primary. Item ID is going to be primary key. Index primary. And you have this another one called AI, another column called AI. Under that, there's a little checkbox. Make sure it is selected, checked. Only for item ID field. AI means here, not artificial intelligence, auto increment. This defines auto increment. So that I have created an item ID, which is going to have integers, which are whole numbers, which is going to be positive in this case, because I have mentioned AI, auto increment. Automatically, these numbers will be inserted. We don't have to insert any numbers into this. Automatically, for each record, for each item name that I'm going to insert, automatically numbers will be created within the database. Okay, so double check, item ID, int, index primary, AI ticked, and then item name, type varchar, length 100, that's all for it. AI is not selected for that. There is no index for that. And then click save. The meaning of AI is auto increment. Someone is asking in the group chat. The meaning of AI is auto increment. And then here click save button. I hope all of you have achieved this step up to this extent. Okay, so proceeding with the rest.
Guys, turn off your mics, everybody.
Okay, I'll turn off all of their mics.
Sir?
You want me to turn off my mic as well?
No.
Okay.
I joke.
Okay, fine, fine. Right? Job done, back to this. Please, all the mics are muted now, except mine. So here, wait, four people are in the waiting queue. Right, all 100 are back. So here we have created items table inside lib database. I hope you can remember. I mean, what we just did in the previous session. Right, so proceeding with the rest. Let's go back to our insert.php file. Insert.php file, saying again, which I have created inside my downloads. I have USB web server. There is a subfolder called USB web server inside that. And then there is this root folder. And then I have this subfolder called my app, which I have created. And I have two files in there. One is myform.html and the other one is insert.php. So here I have insert.php and I'm going to continue the code. I hope you can remember that we have created the database named live and I have a table called items in there, right? And my items table, I have two columns. One is item ID and the other one is item name, right? So here insert.php, I'm about to complete the file. Please type with me quickly. Do not waste time. This is going to be a bit of a long, a lengthy code, right? So please type along with me. Insert.php file. Type in the rest. So I will explain as I type. First of all, I have to create a connection prior to insert the data. I'm going to first of all create a connection with the database, right? So I'm going to use a variable called $con. Con stands for connection, which I'm going to store the MySQL connection within this variable, right? So here $con variable is created. And here I'm going to use this function, new MySQLi function to get connected to the database. When connecting to this database, the database server, MySQL server. Okay, if it is MySQL server, why do we have MySQLi here? Okay, MySQLi means here, I means improved version. I means improved version, right? So here, this is the improved way of getting connected from a PHP file to a MySQL database. So here, new MySQLi, and I have to send four parameters, which I'm going to enclose within single or double quotes, right? So here, the first one is server name. So since I have stored it locally, my server name is going to be localhost. And the username is going to be root. The password, I hope you can remember, it is USBW. Here the password is the password which we tried, which we used in PHP MyAdmin in order to log into MySQL database server. Right, so I have this root as the username. Password is USBW, and what's going to be the last one? The last one is going to be the database, because you can see here, I have many databases. I have many databases here, right? And I need to connect with only one database, that is live. So here I'm going to mention, therefore, the database name is going to be live. So localhost, username this, password this, please connect to this database and store this connection within this variable $con. If I want to do anything, inserting data, getting data, deleting something, creating something within this database, I have to deal with this $con variable from this point onwards, which means I'm referring to this database via this $con variable. Then, so using this connection, I'm going to insert the data. How to insert the data using this connection? Okay. Our HTML file could submit the content to the PHP file. And PHP file got the content, received the content via the respective method and stored that value within dollar item variable. Now we are trying to implement a connection with our MySQL database. But the problem is, how to talk to a database? Would that be in HTML, in PHP? Databases don't know PHP or HTML. Databases do know only one language, that is SQL. I mean, in this case, according to our syllabus, at least, right? So here, we are going to use SQL, keep our SQL statement prepared to send it to the database. So that database will listen to what I say, what I mention within my SQL statement. So I'm going to prepare my SQL statement and store it in a variable called $SQL. And then I'm mentioning it in here, insert into, what is our table name? Our table name is items. And there is only one column actually which I have to insert the data. I have two columns in there. One is item ID and the other one is item name. I have to input the data only into item name field, because as I told you earlier, item ID, the values are auto-incremented, automatically inserted for each and every record. So I have to just pass the values for item name field. So therefore I'm mentioning here, insert it to items, but not entirely into items for items table, not for all the columns, but for item name column, values. What exactly is the value going to be? The value is going to be the value which I have entered into this text box of my HTML form. This text box name is item name, which I have got the value in here, captured the value in here, received the value at the PHP end, which is now stored in a variable called $item. So I'm going to go ahead and pass that value in here, $item. So that whatever the value that I have entered via my HTML form is going to appear here. For example, if I'm going to input their pen, you'll be able to see here, insert into items, item name, values, and here I'll be able to see pen, right? So instead of this $item, that's going to appear. So my SQL statement is prepared. My connection is there. Now what I have to do, insert the data. So this is what I'm going to do now. If, because two things can happen. Either this statement, if this connection is created, if this SQL statement is correct, if both are all right, then our SQL, our MySQL server is going to accept this and do the needful. Or otherwise, another thing can happen, that is, it is going to throw us an error. So I'm having a if statement here. If there is an error, I should say that, sorry, we could not insert the data. But if it is true, if it has happened, then we should be able to say data inserted successfully, right? So here, if statement, inside if statement, I'm going to mention $connections query. $connections query is going to be the SQL statement. The $connection query, in the sense our connection has a query now, that query is which I have mentioned within my $SQL variable, which is this SQL statement. If this is true, the result of this query is true, which is coming from the database. If it is true, then which means we have inserted the data successfully. We can say item inserted. If it is not, else, we can say fail to insert the item. Fail to insert the item. Insert or retrieve, update or whatever. If you have created a connection, finally you have to end it. $con, close. So this is my code. First of all, I will check whether this is working or not. And if this is working, I'll come back to the screen and I'll show you the code. Okay, fine. So save this. I'm going to save this. And then just go to localhost. And localhost via the USB web server. My app. myform.html. Do not forget that I have not straight away accessed myform.html by just double clicking on it. I have accessed the HTML file via localhost. Localhost. And then myform.html. Click on this. Enter the item name. I'm going to insert a pen here. Pen. Insert item. Click insert item. You can see item inserted. Yes. Item inserted. Not sure. Do not be too happy. Just check whether the item is actually inserted or not. How to check it? Go to the database. Live items. When you click on the table name or when you click on the browse button, you'll be able to see pen is inserted. You can see here, pen is inserted. And you can see automatically item ID is generated for that. Automatically the item ID is generated for that. Number one, pen. Okay. I'll try inserting another one. Go back. Let's say eraser. Insert item. Item inserted. Go to the database. Click browse again. You can see number two, eraser. It has been inserted. This is what I mean by auto increment. Item ID is automatically incremented and assigned for each record. So going back to the PHP code, for the ones also who could not complete, please complete the PHP code now.